Foxhook and Sharper Trades, a mixed day on Wall Street today. Some tension with the White House and the Congress, having difficulties agreeing on the stimulus plan. And that's where we saw this bit of a reversal at one point. Fortunately, the support at 335 held and got a little bit of a bounce. So we might see some of this tension play out for the next few days. And the S&P 500 is testing the all-time high, 309.08, very close. So that's a big resistance. The Nasdaq 100 blew above it when it was testing this high right here. But that's a different story. It's a different index. And as you can see, the NDX is trending since it broke out. The S&P 500 is trending since the breakout here, but there is this resistance right there. That's huge. So we'll see if he's able to pick it out or not. Right now is struggling a little bit. We'll see. The technicals obviously remain bullish as long as price remains above the 50 simple, the moving average. That's quite a ways down. If it pulls back, it could be quite a reversal. But you know, for now, everything is bullish. The channel bottom is holding, the 80 is holding, so this is all bullish. Take a look at the individual stocks, day trades and swing. Except for one, most of them, all the others are either consolidating or pulling back a little bit. So starting with the, and by the way, next week, I'm going to finish up a few things with the day trading platform. And then I will start inviting some of you swing traders into the room. Since there's a large number of you, it's gonna be a gradual access. I don't want to overwhelm the system and the platform. I want to make sure everything works smoothly for the day traders. But that's the idea. Eventually, everybody will be, everybody who has an active membership will get access to the training room. Not the day trading. That's only for day traders, those that purchase the package. Okay, so starting with ADT. ADT is in consolidation. I like this breakout here, good consolidation above 11. Yesterday I sent you an entry opportunity near 12. It's in consolidation. This is not moving quite yet. The important line is there are two very tight stops. 1150, which is this low right here, 1150, and 11, they're both very close to obviously protect. There is a big resistance at 1256. We need to see a price popping all above that. In that case, if it does it, we'll see an extension. My first target is 1389, 1532, and 1672. AMC, this was a day trade that worked really well and actually looks like it might be a swing possibility. Broke above the 50 and extended. Inside the 1 minute chart, this is how we traded. Big breakout and then a pullback held the support at 450, 470 area. Pull was pushing the five and then eventually was able to pop, extend it to 540, a pullback, test the VWP. This is an idea. When it does this, push, pull back, consolidate, usually wants to go for more and he ran all the way up to 570 channel top. There was a big seller at 560, was able to fill but didn't take price down, wasn't until he reached 580, 570 area and broke out eventually to the downside. So this is done. But again, looks interesting, could extend. And if he does 651, 615 and 682, the support is fine and the 50 simple the moving average. But Lord, well, I was mentioned multiple times, mentioned here, consolidated, popped. We day traded yesterday. Actually, yesterday was an entry opportunity when I say it was stabilizing. I was able to look like it was making a good base and it was ready to make a move. And it did. I'm going into yesterday action right here, consolidation. And today popped. Wait. Yeah. And here. Consolidation across the VWP. This was a good indication they wanted to go higher. It did today with a positive opening and extension. And today I gave you an entry also as a swing. When it blew out the water, pulled back, this was very bullish with this kind of volume. Extended to 32, there's a big, big seller at 32, and then pulled back. We have an entry at 31.40. Currently it's working. I mean, it's a nice breakout of this area. This is the all-time high, Yes, so breaking the all-time high record, which was yesterday, 3118, this company was added to the S&P 500, there's large volume. This does not trade a lot of volume, but the past couple of days is significant. It was added again to the index, looking for 33, 35, and 37. We'll see if it gets support, 30 and 29. Blink, this is now off the list. However, I'm seeing in the aftermarket market, it's already getting a little bit of a pop following earnings. So it looks positive earnings. You held onto the position. It's reached the target at 13, actually resistance at 13. So far it's bullish, the testing 12. Let's see if it extends. It needs to break out of the 13.32, target 16.42 and 20.02. The support are, currently, well, it remains 12 and 10. CHWI, this is an idea, was an idea here, Ren put back, could be an entry opportunity since he was able to hold the support at 50, pop the 52, this is the recent high, the autumn actually, and it's testing and holding nicely. Tempting a breakout, needs more volume to confirm, look for a move above this low. 56. My targets are 60, 66, and 71. Support 52 and 50. Faye, it's still in consolidation. This worked here. Nice. We enter at 15.30, 15.40, somewhere in the area. Rally to 16.19, a little bit of a move, and then 3 days pullback. Obviously, this is not working at the moment. It's still in consolidation. The bottom line needs to hold this low, 14.73, and I need to see a breakout above 16.28 before this thing gets going. That will be our first target. Next target, 17.40 and 18.34. Fossil, this was a day trade that also worked very well. Broke out big volume. This could extend on positive earnings. The target is 6.21, above that 6.73 and 7.47. Support is, this is a bullish kicker on volume. Support is today low at 4.70. GRWG, this was another fantastic day trade. The bullish kicker breakout. Reached the first target, second target, and extended as high as 12.75, trended for a good part of the day until eventually broke the support right here. Was a big seller at 12.50 or 60 area and went down. Held the support of the VWP and then went strong again into the close. So this might want to go higher. If it does, 13.41, 14.80, and 16.45. Half of this candle is your stop, 11. Hull was upgraded to a conviction buy by Goldman Sachs. That's a powerful upgrade. Looks very strong with a target of 20. For us, our targets are 17.56, 19.02, and 20.56. Looks very strong. Broke out to the 200. There's a good base at 200 and the ATMA. You can use those as your support, or 16 and 15. Allora, this is an idea, trade idea. Looks very bullish, Susan pointed out today. Big volume is coming in. Looks like it's ready for a breakout. There's a big seller at 30. If it breaks through, this could extend. 30, 70, 32, and 33.53 channel top. The support, the ATMA, 28.70, and this low at 27.50, 27.40. Home reached the second target today. Pills them off, even though it's a breakout of this high. Let's see, 16.35, close the above. So that's a breakout. And the second target always pills them off, you know, and raise the stop, 16 and 15. I'm looking for channel top, which will be near, the third target will be 18.89, and the channel top could be 20. The fourth target, 21.11, looks very strong. The ATMA is your benchmark. Maxim, an idea, I like this side of consolidation. Most important, I like this big volume right here. Pop, pullback consolidation about 66. If it breaks out of 71.58 and holds, my targets are 75, 80, and possibly 86. The support 68 and 60, 5. Net in consolidation, this is not getting a break quite yet. Yeah, I need to see a move above 40. That's a key area. It needs to pop with volume. That's the area we need to see move. Technicals are still a little bit bearish because this is a big resistance. So I need to see this 40 pop very soon. What I don't want to see is a pullback below 38. A break below 38 will come here and test the 50, which is our secondary support around 36. 38 and 36 primary and secondary support, still in consolidation. My targets are 40 to 40, 45 and 48. NTN, fantastic day traders, blow out the water, massive move. Ran from 3 to 7, reached multiple targets. We traded here and then at the steep pullback, and then we re-enter a position here, rallied to my target, pull back, and then traded for the next several hours until you reach 7. At that point, this was a massive sellout. And that was the target, 778 done. Big volume though, 207 million traded shares. This thing could extend this kind of volume. It's often a catalyst for much higher prices, but there's also a longer upper shadow. So I would say now for us it's done, but if you continue to trade, your stop is below 360. On is pulling back a little bit after the breakout and retest of the 22, is now pulling back. Number volume picked up a little bit, is testing the 80MA. Our support are 2150 and 2070. I need to see price hold come back above 22.10. That's an important area. So right now it's in pullback consolidation. My targets are 2383. 2570 and 2781. Pen another day trade that might extend. The bullish, the technicals are very bullish. Volume is good. 59, 62, and 66. Pins, also in consolidation. Big volume yesterday, that's what prompted the entry alert right here near 30, 35, 50, 35, 40, somewhere in this area. It's all in the support at the ATMA. We have both tight stop for this particular stock, 34.50, I believe, and 33.50. My targets are 37.14, this resistance right here. If it breaks out of this area, this can go vertical, 40, 44, and 48. RVLV, another day trade that didn't do much other than a drop consolidation and then a good move going into the close, testing the resistance at 2389. Looks interesting, could extend. And if it does, analysts give a target of 34, 25, 28, 30, 32, and that's your 34.70. Support is today low, 21.50. STC, that's what happens, you see, earnings. That's why I took it off the list. Earnings can go either way. This one went down. As I mentioned yesterday in the after hour market, when I saw the reversal, it was obvious it was gonna go lower. Sometimes they recover, this is now a bearish kick, it's gonna go down. Snap still in consolidation. Technicals are improving a little bit. The volume remains bullish, but small. A little bit of a balance of power indecision, so the bears and bulls are fighting equal strength. And our support are very tight, 21.50 and 20.50. I need to see a breakout above the 50 in the trend line. My targets are 23.88, 25.77, and 27.68. With this TikTok business going on, there's some tension around this particular company, but we'll see. So far, the base it's holding, that's what matters. I need to see a breakout. And Zillow is not working. After having worked here, and here as an entry, still consolidating and it's holding the 80MA. So this remains in the list, but I wanna see for this to start working is to move above the closing price of the breakout day, which was, let's call it 80. And my targets are 82, 81, 91, and 101. All right, folks, thanks for watching. Good trading, see you tomorrow.